There was a lot of pressure by many people. For both Murang'a and for both Nairobi. Some from very high echelons. And I was very clear that at the time I wanted to support the politics of the day rather than get involved. But everybody, most of the people who came to talk to me felt that Nairobi was in very bad shape. And the same question you're asking me, I asked them. Why are you putting pressure on me here? Why not where I'm used to? And you know, being the capital city, being almost 60% of our GDP, there was a lot of persuasion. And the people who approached me in good faith, and they meant well. But there were dark forces that were already very fearful of 2022 succession, and felt that if I succeeded in Nairobi, I would close them out in 2022. And that was why the nomination of Jubilee was marred with a lot of rigging, a lot of manipulation. As a matter of fact, we produced evidence to show that we never lost the nomination at Nairobi. We did not. And
those that person that you're referring to, you understand they were in that position that you referred to, that there had been an assurance that you get the Jubilee ticket, and that by then we should change the DP, who was the center of the Jubilee.
As I said, people who I believe in persuaded me it would be best for Nairobi, and I got convinced and I got persuaded, and they meant well. The people who are persuading me had the best interests, but as I said, there were dark forces that were not convinced, or dark forces that saw it as a 2022 succession and decided that the best thing was to age me out at the time. And I made it absolutely clear that I knew who they were, and I mentioned. Yes. And truth be told, the choices they brought in brought this county further down than it had been in at the time. At the time. And in fact, it took President's intervention with the LMS to try and just reinstate basic services to the Nairobians.
Would that explain why you're on your side?
No.